night, everyone. Hope you're well. Yes, hope you're well. So, it has taken exactly 1 month to do what usually takes about 2 weeks to do, and that is ferment a lovely braggot with citra hops, or, you know, honey beer, whichever one floats your boat. So it has been a little bit colder, and even though I had the heating on, it was just a slow fermentation. That's what happens. I could have used a heat mat, got some kicking around somewhere, but this whole channel is meant to be cheap and cheerful, so I practice what I preach and I don't use heat belts. If it takes longer, it takes longer. That's just how it goes. So we are going to be bottling up today and priming the bottles. So I have my usual 2 liter bottles. Lovely, clear, ooh, sexy. They're all sterilized. Now the reason I use 2 liter bottles is one, it's easy because you can buy these really cheap, all of mine is sparkling water, but I really like it. Number two is, this is my pint glass. I mean, here's the pint glass that's in my hydrometer. There is a little bit of difference, so it takes 2 to 3 of these to top this up. And I don't want to do that, that's just a waste of time. But I also have some very sexy pop top bottles. I actually bought these, not homebrew wild and cheap style, but they were so cheap, they're like £6 for 12 of them from B&M of all places, and they're brown. I haven't actually seen brown pop top bottles, that's why I normally buy the Grouch that comes with the beer, because they have the green pop top bottles. Anyway, not why we're here, so let's get the beer. And here it is, looking lovely. I mean, it's got a beautiful color to it. It's a little bit, whoa. Now, I haven't checked in here. I've just been watching the lid, because that's what I do. I don't watch the fermenter. I've been doing it for quite a while now, so I know when it's still brewing and when it's not. So I'm gonna crack it open. I'm gonna stick the hydrometer in. We're gonna see what it finished at. Oh, that smells good. It has, obviously it has a hop smell. Oh, then I've got sort of beer with honey. Oh, it's actually really, really good. Really good, considering it was a lager kit. So let's grab the hydrometer and let's dump it in. Has a nice color to it as well. So, that's gonna take a second. That smells so good. Smell-o-vision, they need to invent it because this smells really good. So, ooh, there we go. The hydrometer has stopped and it is reading right at, of course, it's in between. It's not a whole number. 1.008. Ooh, 1.008. That's pretty good. Now we started, if I was correct, 1.050, so that makes it about 5.5%. Oh yes, that's pretty good. Now it is slightly over the usual 1.005 that you get from the beer kits, but we used honey, and honey isn't completely fermentable, so yeah, it worked out about right. Since honey is a natural product, the amount of infermentable sugars varies. So, that's gonna be good. So, yeah, don't need that anymore, ha, fortunately. So, I'm gonna go ahead and bottle up, because I can. So I've got my lovely siphoning tube. Ooh, my brewing peg. It's all been sterilized, including my laptop. I should have said that. Got my lovely slither of silver, because I'm fancy like that. In it goes. Obviously, if you're using a proper siphon, it comes with the straight tube, but this works. Now it's all tangled. Yeah, that's about right. In it goes. Brewing peg. And there is some fresh water in here, so it'll create its own siphon. Don't need to muck about. So I'll see you in a bit. So these little siphon tubes, because this is not a standard homebrew siphon tube, it is like a really cheap one, you know, just the tube. It's one of the reasons why I use the wire, because you can bend it and shape it, which you can't do with the standard ones. It's just a but this really thin board, it's like 3 or 4 mil on the inside, really great for wines and things like that. It gives you a lot more control. But when you're doing a large batch, like a 5-gallon batch, like we did here, it takes forever. It's actually taken, I don't know, an hour and a half, an hour and 45 minutes to do the bottling. That's a long time. Really should invest in some new tubes. Anyway, I'm going to get rid of this and we'll continue. Right, and there we have it. We have many bottles. So, from our 23-liter batch of honey beer, we have 22 and a half bottles of liters worth of booze, and it looks pretty damn fantastic. I mean, it has a nice color. I mean, it's still looking good. It's lovely. So we're going to be carbonating these bottles, and I keep a very simple rule, which is 1 teaspoon per liter. So for those people that want weights, because they're like, oh, I must use weight, that's about 4 grams-ish, give or take. Now, the reason I do that is, one, I like not a lot of carbonation. I like to drink my drinks and not belch everywhere. Just, you know, you don't want to be bloated when you're having a drink. So I go light on the carbonation. Plus, because I go a little lighter on the carbonation, I don't have to be as, like, accurate with weights, because they drive me mad. So what I've got is I have a funnel. Now, for these 2-liter bottles, the finger funnel works really well because of the lids and how it's set up. But for the pop tops, because it needs to have a good seal and it's all rubberized, best to use a funnel. Now, what we're going to be carbonating with is just granulated cheap sugar. Now, I have a teaspoon, which I'll use for the 2-liter ones, because I only need 2 teaspoons, because they're 2 liters, and I have a 1/2 teaspoon measurement. But again, you can still use the old teaspoon, but I happen to have one, so I'm going to use it. So let us begin. So roughly 1/2 teaspoon. It doesn't matter if it's slightly sticking out. It's, like I said, plenty of wriggle room. So in goes that. Yep, it's all the sugar. It was also sterilized. And then you give it a damn good shake to mix in the sugar, otherwise it doesn't really do a lot. So I'm gonna go ahead and do all of these bottles, because I'm cool. Pure laziness. All right. 2 teaspoons, that much. That much, it's about right. There we go, and then shake it like you mean it. Right, seems to be all dissolved. It's got a nice head on it. Ooh. Right, so all of our bottles have been carbonated. Well, potentially carbonated, primed, that's the word. Brain farts. And now we've just got to leave them alone. So usually it takes about 2 weeks before these are ready, but it is a little bit colder, so we will do the tasting video in 2.5 weeks. Oh yes, by that point it should be carbonated and it should be conditioned, and in theory, these should be nice and clear. In theory, we'll see how it actually turns out. So I really hope you enjoyed this video, guys. I'm giving you some ideas for some strange beers. Don't forget to check out some of the other videos and, well, subscribe if you feel like it. Get on homebrewing.